Hey, folks, thanks for joining us. It would be an understatement to say it's been a great half for the Charlotte Hornets.
We use a lot of hyperbole around here. I can't even spell hyperbole, but I know what we use it. But it actually looks like they're doing just that. Passing drills out there. The ball movement is insane.
Us? Use hyperbole. We wouldn't do that in a million years. Next up, let's see who made the honors for our NBA Players of the Week. And in the West, Ja Morant.
Well, Ja Morant has certainly been one of the most exciting guys to watch. The athleticism, are you kidding me? Never passes up an opportunity for a big play. But also does the other stuff. Control the pace, run the offense. He's the complete package.
And that'll do it for us. Thanks for stopping by. We'll head back down to Brian Anderson and crew for the start of the third quarter.
But you've got to appreciate their masterful performance.
And I'm sure their fans appreciated it too. We saw the outstanding defense and a loaded offensive effort. They were just dominant out there.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. So for Grant Hill, Allie LaForce, and Steve Smith, I'm Brian Anderson, thanking everyone for watching tonight's game. We'll see you next time.
MP!
Mr. Cruz.
Nice to finally meet you, bro.
Truly, man. I was about to say the same thing, man. Hey, you are a hard guy to get in touch with.
I don't know what you're talking about, man. These are my streets out here.
Now, I ain't mean it no type of way, man, but listen, Mr. Cruz, man, I've been wanting to ball at Hammond Park for a long time, man, so this means the world to
me. Look at it. Look at it, MP. Of course you have. Of course you want to ball here, but you got to prove that you love this game and that you love this beautiful city.
And somehow, someway, Shep was able to do that.
Shep. Now look, MP, Shep is a lot of things, not all of which I approve, but Shep has been coming here since he was a kid. Like, look at them kids over there playing basketball.
Yeah.
Shep, he respects Hammond Park, and he knows what it's all about.
For sure. I mean, he and I, we don't see eye to eye, so, you know.
Oh, I've noticed. Which is why I think you would appreciate the opportunity to play this year's Classic.
Mr. Cruz, man, you have no idea, man. Like, these people need to know what I'm about out here.
Mm-hmm. That's good. Because I've been watching you play, son. And I'm impressed. Which is why I think you should put together a team for this year's Classic.
For real?
Mm-hmm.
For real?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Don't play with me, man.
MP, I want you to be a captain. Okay? There's only four every year, so that's a big honor.
No, I know what it means, man. Mr. Cruz, this means the world to me, man.
Hey,
truly.
Hey, you put in the work. You deserve it.
Yes, sir. So, but I gotta just put a team together or something like that?
Yeah. Best of the best play out here. Pick any three people you want.
Right.
No such thing as a ringer.
All right. I think I got some people in mind.
Good. Now get to work.
Yes, sir.
I think you're going to change a lot of minds around here.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Mr. Cruz.
I heard you met Kenny Cruz. That guy's my hero. What a baller.
Okay, so you finally met the great Kenny Cruz. How did it go?
Well, he gave me an invite, and I'm one of this year's Classic captains.
Yeah. Let's go! That's
Let's get it!
Come on!
How dare you? Oh, I'm so proud of you, MP.
I am pumped right now.
Yo, who you gonna run with, though?
Oh, I already got a squad, bro. I just gotta say when.
He's been recruiting for a while now.
Oh, man, I got Hero, Cole, and T-Mac.
Okay,
yes.
That's what I'm talking
yes.
about.
Yes, I love it. This
look
is
at you two.
Oh,
I'm texting them right now, man.
Yo, you know what nice. I can't wait for? To see the look on Shep's face when you walk in with that crew.
Man, I've been picturing that moment for a long time now.
This is your city, babe. And you know what?
Indeed.
The final boss is Hammond
All right.
Park.
Yo, my pointer. You found it.
Yeah, it was under the couch cushions. Along with some loose change and a couple of chocolate-covered pretzels, which... You know what? Could we all be a little neater with food around here? Someone left a cinnamon roll on the counter yesterday and it was covered with ants.
That's Ricky.
I don't do carbs.
Okay, I'm sorry about that. I was stress eating.
Wait, why are you stressed, bro?
Look, everyone's got their struggles, MP, but look, I don't need you worried about me at all. I just need you to stay focused on the Classic, right?
Don't worry about me, man.
Okay,
I got this.
That's what I'm talking about.
Put the cinnamon rolls away.
Oh, my man K, what's good, family?
What's good, bro? You want to hoop? I'm about to hit the courts.
Come on, fam. You know I'm down to hoop.
All right, let's go. Horse. I was on tour with niggas that's so raw. Started selling white, we won't sell it no more. Like Trump ain't feeling us, cops still killing us. Niggas taking shots, can't stop me. They ain't real enough. Cut her off, act like she did, and it's killing her. New.
So, you're back.
That was a second-rate introduction. Your lack of pageantry is disappointing.
You sound like you're auditioning for the part of a comic book villain.
Untrue. I would be the hero. And with an attitude like that, I may reconsider my choice of sidekick.
No, please don't.
You know, I don't want to interrupt, but I really do think you guys look great in tights. Just saying.
Enough with the pleasantries, though I do look good in tights. Let the quizzing commence. According to the members of Run DMC, while Peter Piper picked peppers, Run did what?
Ooh, rocked rhymes. Humpty Dumpty fell down. That's his hard time. Huh?
Precisely right.
Woo! Sorry.
Which rock artist had a brother who was also part of his band?
That's a really good question. Eddie Van Halen.
Don't pull a muscle patting yourself on the back. What is the opening chord of the Beatles' A Hard Day's Night?
Wait, what?
I'm just kidding. Kim Gordon provided indefectible bass and vocals for what group of noise rock pioneers?
Sonic Youth. Mm-hmm.
Correct.
Let's go.
Well, color me surprised. When faced with the arduous trials we set before you, you triumphed. Your knowledge is vast and medal exemplary. We congratulate you.
Calm down, Marv. You've exceeded our low expectations. Kudos.
What he said.
Oh,
the pad. Ain't no way. That's why y'all couldn't get that board. Ball don't lie. I got that. Oh, wrong cat. No, won't. Get down.
Like a man. Look.
Thanks for stopping by, y'all. First up on the show tonight, a quick look ahead of some upcoming games on the docket. How far down the road would you guys look on the schedule over the course of a season?
Straight to the playoff, man. I was focused on the long game.
The long game? You must be talking about your golf game.
Well, you're gonna start talking smack? Golf smack? Come on. You wanna go there?
Taking some time now to look at our matchup. Well, everything is going right for the Hornets.
We use a lot of hyperbole around here. I can't even spell hyperbole, but I know what we use it. But it actually looks like they're doing just that. Passing drills out there. The ball movement is insane.
Us? Use hyperbole. We wouldn't do that in a million years. And that'll do it for us. Thanks for stopping by. We'll head back down to Brian Anderson and crew for the start of the third quarter.
Charlotte takes this one by a big margin. This one wasn't even close. The hometown crowd was waiting for a miracle that never came.
Yeah, and this team was consistent throughout. They met every challenge, and they earned this dub.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. This is Brian Anderson saying thank you for tuning in. We'll see you later.
If I'm Phil Boyer and my GM is telling me either I go or MP goes, then I'm sorry, but it's you who has to go. MP has been a model citizen and a winning player. There's absolutely no reason to give up on him this early and give away all your draft capital for a player in Shep Owens who, yes, he's looked impressive, but not more impressive than MP, Perk.
JJ, I totally disagree. Othello, I support you, buddy. Phil Boyer should have never overruled you on draft day. And Shep Owens should be playing for the city. Simple as that. And now that you're trying to undo your boss' obvious mistake, they want to make it your problem? Ridiculous.
Perk, you're like a broken record. I know you've got a narrative to support here, but you have to admit that MP has played better than expected.
No, I don't.
Come on.
Well, I didn't expect much, so that's a no big accomplishment. And I'm sorry, JJ, but it's nothing he's done has shown me he has a higher ceiling than Shep. If Shep's team is foolish enough to give him away, I'm giving up MP. I'm giving up my draft picks. I'm giving up everything that's not nailed down. You want to win a chip someday? Shep is that dude.
Carry on. Just wanted to give it a go.
I like it, though.
Thank you.
Oh, my God.
Nikki, what's going on? How are you?
Good to see you. So I've got a few questions for you about the classic.
I don't know that's what you want to talk about.
Well, what's your status? Are you playing?
Oh, yeah. The classic is something that definitely excites me. I mean, just the history of it, how many great players have gone there and, you know, continue to hoop at their highest level, things like that.
Have you gotten a chance to connect with Kenny Crews?
Yeah. I've actually had the honor to, yeah. You know, wow. You can't hoop at Hammond without his say-so. And it was so important for me to do things the right way, to respect the tradition. So, yeah, we had a nice conversation. He's a cool dude.
I bet. So, what are your thoughts on going up against Shep Owens? I mean, he was the captain of last year's championship team.
I don't really think too much about that. I mean, he's just an obstacle that's in my way. But the more important thing is getting to play at Hammond, because that's hollow ground right there.
Yes.
And I've got a great team that I'm looking forward to playing with. I've hooped with them individually, but not together as a team just yet. So I'm really looking forward to that, seeing how that dynamic plays out.
Well, can you tell me who's on your squad?
Ooh, I knew you were gonna ask that, but you know, I want to have a little bit of showmanship, so I'm gonna keep it a surprise
for now. All right, fair enough. Thanks, MP. I'm looking forward to seeing you at the Classic.
You know what I'm saying, though?
How you feeling about that Classic, baby? Mm-hmm.
Looking forward to it, bro. The streets been saying they miss me.
Yeah.
But you're not worried about MP? I mean, I heard he got some hoopers on his squad.
Man, I don't care who MP. He got. We got me.
That's why I like this, baby.
Man, this belt ain't going nowhere.
At home right there, baby.
Matter of fact, them green jerseys y'all be wearing, right? You think you hook me up one? They're kind
of
tight.
Those are for the wins of the Classic, bro. So, no, I don't think I can hook you up with them.
Yeah, come on, bro. You know I could win the Classic. Matter of fact, why don't you ever ask me to hoop? You always be hooping, don't ever ask.
Bro.
What? Come on, man. You know I was an all-star. Sixth grade church league, you remember? I was going crazy.
Bro.
Look, all I'm saying is, somebody get hurt. I mean, just sub me in.
No
just,
way.
My crossover mean, bro. You know what I'm saying?
I'll keep that in mind.
Yeah, I know you got me.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know.
Man, you know you can't hoop.
Shep, he's funny like a clown. You like clowns, right? I'm gonna just
Why don't
some
you focus
emails
on
to
the
answer for you, but
the media, correct?
Got it.
We're back again. Welcome. It's that time again to take a peek at how the mid-season power rankings are shaping up. And Shaq, as a player, did you ever look at power rankings to see how other teams were measuring up?
I can't say I did, Ernie, because no one measures up to me.
Big guys always want to make it about height, always.
Now, looking at the first half of play in our featured game, what a disaster it's been for the Knicks.
Their effort on the board has been horrendous. That's a good way to get blown out. Only way they could turn this thing around is to start winning the rebounding battle, to win the battle of possession. Otherwise, they're my favorite, avocado toast.
Thanks for joining us. Now let's toss it to Kevin Harlan for the start of the second half.
Dominic showing in front of a crowd that loved every minute of it.
And you know, this game could really be a defining one for what they can do when they are playing at their best. I mean, being here at home, no doubt helps, and the execution was flawless.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. So for David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, Brent Berry, and the whole 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for being with us. See you next time.
Unbelievable game, MP. Playing your tail off out there.
Thank you, Coach. Thank you.
That trade rumor really lit a fire into you, huh?
Man, all I keep thinking about is being better than Shep. I mean, I am literally obsessed right now.
This team still wants to trade you after this run you're on? I'll resign. No cap. Okay. I'm serious. I am serious. You've been that good. I don't want to work for an organization that can't see that.
I hate to break up this little love fest you got going on here, but MP, you're wanted in the press room.
Make sure to let them know. This is your team now.
It's time for you to plead your case. Now, I don't want you to take any questions when you're in there.
No questions?
No. Talk about why you've proven that you belong here. all right? You'll never have a better chance than now. Support for this trade on social, it's dipped below 10%.
So you want to strike while the iron's hot?
Exactly. Speak from the heart. And then
leave. It sounds so easy, though.
It will be. You've got this, MP. It's your time.
I see you, Ash.
Yeah.
What's going on, everybody?
I figured we'd do this thing a little bit different this time. So we're gonna hold the questions and I'm gonna just talk to y'all for a little bit. Now, ever since I was drafted, there's been talks about if I belong here or not. You know, first it came from the fans, then it came from the talking heads, and then it came from people within my own organization questioning my skill, my heart, and my leadership. And through all those attacks, I kept my head down. I kept my mouth shut, and I worked to the bone. I did everything that I could to make sure this team wins. I did everything that I could to make sure that people in my community are thriving. And I did everything that I could to make sure the people around me found success. But where does that get me? On the trading block. And for Shep Owens, of all people. Someone who I've been outperforming my entire career. This future star you speak about. What does he do better than me? Does he jump high? Run faster? What? Stronger? What? Give me something. But that's cool. Because I win games. So my question to you is, what matters more? Highlight plays or championships? Because if you want to talk about a leader, the only person that Shep Owens has led is Shep Owens himself. That is it. He has no idea what it means to be a leader. He has no idea what it means to be a part of a team or a community. He has no idea about any of that. That guy is simply all ego and no heart. I mean, how can I make it more clear that I am exactly what the city needs? I mean, if the tape doesn't do it, and the numbers don't do it, and the people whose lives I've affected positively doesn't do it, what's gonna do it? I mean, the people attacking me, do they even care anymore? Or do they just wanna sell you a narrative? But you know what? That's of the past. Because I'm here to stay. So I just need for you guys just to get behind me on this one. Just trust me on this one. I am exactly who you guys need to be leading this team, to be the man of this city. So all I'm asking is just trust me. Because soon enough, you will see. Thank you guys for your time.
There he is, boys. He is. Face the franchise.
Appreciate you guys. Thank you. Way to step up. I got you.
I just got a request from Top Takes Daily. They want to have you on to talk about that epic rant.
Okay, so it played well.
Oh, yeah. Social is buzzing. They're calling it your superstar moment.
Okay, that sounds good.
It's very good, and Top Takes Daily is just going to amplify your message. I'd say the chances of you getting traded at this point are between, I don't know, 0% and 2%.
So it's still possible.
Well, yeah, anything is possible, but I'll take the 98% odds. This is great. You should shower before you get to that studio, because it's overwhelming. Go. Meet me at the studio. Get dressed, go, shower thoroughly. Come on.